Hi, my name is John Eggert.
And I'm Pam Eggert, and I'm a member of the parish board. Please join us in saying, Life is a gift for which we are grateful. We gather in community to celebrate the glory and the mystery of this great gift.
Hi, my name is Chris Holton Jablonski, and it is my great joy and my deep honor to serve you as your minister and to welcome you to another wonderful worship service. Today, a very special service because it also is July 4th. And I can't recall, one of you will probably look this up, but I can't recall the last time we've had Sunday, a July 4th Sunday. So welcome. I'm so grateful for the gift of your attention. And for this worship service, we get to hear from Devin Malkin, who's written an original poem for today. And then I get to talk a little bit, and we have wonderful music again. We are now thick into the summertime flow, and we have our summertime worship team. We'll be coming to you every week, on-demand worship, ready for you at your convenience. Also, stay tuned. We have our online coffee hour next Sunday on the 11th. And there's announcements. There's going to be four over the summer. So mark your calendar if you like. It's a wonderful opportunity to connect. And wanted to say thank you also to everybody who participated in the hygiene pack drive. Along with our partners in the Belmont Religious Council, we created 325. Of the hygiene packs, which is fantastic. It'll help the Bridge Kids Give Back organization, who brings these to unhoused folks, many of whom are just struggling so hard. And so this makes a huge difference. This gets them the packs they need for the whole summer. So thank you. So many of you participated both in making the packs, but then also in donating things. So it was a great success, and we're sure to do it again. And if you'd like to be more involved in that effort, you can contact Jess Hicks, and I can get you connected to Jess as well. So do please reach out. There's so much wonderful work going on supporting these folks. So for now, welcome. Come, let us worship together.
Peace for lands and dream of an America where people radiate confidence and there isn't judgment of any sense. No matter what clothes, shoes, or hair we wear, people will be loved everywhere. We can be who we are, and the dreams we chase are never too far. We can share what's inside, and feelings won't be forced to hide. And every day when we get home, we will know we aren't alone.
This is the time in our service where we invite forward an offering to help support the good work of the church and our partners in the wider world. We are so grateful for all of our wonderful IT folks in the database world, Miriam Baker especially, who has set up this great new mechanism. So if you want, you can text the word offering to 617-819-8168. And all of your offerings, all of the online offerings for the month of July will be shared with our partners in the wider world. So do please text. We are so grateful for all you are about to give.
I was born by the river, a little tent. Just like that river I've been running ever since. It's been a long time coming, but I know change is gonna come. Whoa. It's been too hard living, but I'm afraid to die, 'cause I don't know what's up there beyond the sky. It's been a long time coming.
America be America again by Langston Hughes. Let America be America again. Let it be the dream it used to be. Let it be the pioneer on the plain seeking a home where he himself is free. America was never America to me. Let America be the dream the dreamers dreamed. Let it be that great, strong land of love, where never kings connive nor tyrants scheme, that any man may be crushed by one above. It never was America to me. Oh, let my land be a land where liberty is crowned with no false patriotic wreath, but opportunity is real and life is free. Equality is in the air we breathe. There's never been equality for me, nor freedom in this homeland of the free. Say, who are you that mumbles in the dark? And who are you that draws your veils across the stars? I am the poor white, fooled and pushed apart. I am the Negro bearing slavery scars. I am the red man driven from the land. I am the immigrant clutching the hope I seek and finding only the old stupid plan of dog eat dog, of mighty crush the weak. I am the young man full of strength and hope, tangled in that ancient endless chain of profit, power, gain, of grab the land, of grab the gold, of grab the ways of satisfying need, of work the men, of take the pay, of owing everything for one's own greed. I am the farmer, bondsman to the soil. I am the worker sold to the machine. I am the Negro servant to you all. I am the people, humble, hungry, mean. Hungry yet today, despite the dream. Beaten yet today, oh pioneers. I am the man who never got ahead, the poorest worker bartered through the years, yet I'm the one who dreamt our basic dream in the old world, who dreamt a dream so strong, so brave, so true, that even yet its mighty daring sings in every brick and stone, in every furrow turned that made America the land it has become. Oh, I'm the man who sailed those early seas in search of what I meant to be my home, for I'm the one who left Ireland's shores and Poland's plains and England's grassy lea, and torn from Black Africa's strand, I came to build a homeland of the free. The free? Who said the free? Not me. Surely not me, the millions on relief today. The millions shot down when we strike, the millions who have nothing for our pay, for all the dreams we've dreamed, for all the songs we've sung, and all the hopes we've held, all the flags we've hung, the millions who have nothing for our pay, except the dream that's almost dead today. Oh, let America be America again, the land that has never yet been, and yet must be. The land where every man is free. The land that's mine, the poor man's, the Indian's, the Negro, me, who made America, whose sweat and blood, whose faith and pain, whose hand at the foundry, whose plow in the rain must bring back our mighty dream again. Sure, call me any ugly name you choose. The steel of freedom does not stain. From those who live like leeches on people's lives, we must take back our land again, America. Oh yes, I say it plain, America never was America to me, and yet I swear this oath, America will be. Out of the rack and ruin of our gangster death, the rape and rot of graft and stealth and lies, we the people must redeem the land, the mines, the plants, the rivers, the mountains, and the endless plain, all stretch of these great green states, and make America again. I have loved this poem for a long time, and I wanted to share it with you all today because it speaks to this moment, this precious and precarious moment we are sharing. So much is possible for our nation right now. So much can be in our future. This last year and a half has made so much clear. If anyone doubted that the powerful sway of white supremacy was still strongly entrenched in this country, these last 2 years have made it clear how far we still have to go to build this land where all people are free. And at the same time, if anyone doubted that there was a hunger for liberation and freedom, that the next generation of activists was apathetic or disengaged, these last 2 years have made it clear that there is a powerful hunger to mobilize and organize, a powerful hunger to build this free and thriving and beautiful democracy, which is still possible. These are the words of Angela Davis. I've come to the conclusion that our work as activists is always to prepare the next generation, to create new terrain so that those who come after us will have a better opportunity to get up and engage in even more radical struggles. And I think we're seeing this now. She says, when we do this work of organizing against racism, heteropatriarchy, capitalism, organizing to change the world, there are no guarantees. To use Stuart Hall's phrase, that our work will have immediate effect, she says, but we have to do it as if it were possible. This is our work, to create these paths, to work for the future generations of dreamers and organizers, to build this nation we know can be. I believe in this work. When I hear the dreams and the voices of our young people, I believe in this future, and not because it is inevitable, actually just the opposite. I believe it is entirely dependent on our hard work, on our organizing, on our making the pathway clear and plain, and inviting people to move along with us. These are the words of Valerie Jarrett, who worked in the Obama White House. Change often seems impossible until it is inevitable. Just as we must own our own lives, we must own our country. For we, the people, are ultimately in control of America's story. Sometimes it is daunting. When the specter of racism and hegemony rears its head, when the demeaning and degrading powers assert themselves, it can seem like there is just so far to go, just so much work to be done. And I can feel daunted. But then there are moments. I think of pride. I think of hundreds of people gathered right back there. I think of all the non-binary children and youth who came and saw their friends and neighbors, saw ministers and police, saw state reps and librarians, and saw and felt so many people gathered to love them, to celebrate them, to say that they are whole and holy, loved and lovable, just as they are, in the truest truth of their beings. I think of them and I have hope. Not because this love and support is inevitable, but because we make it so. Because we choose to create a community in which that love and support is made whole. We choose to create a community in which the very best of our intentions and ideals are made manifest. And we choose to create a country which works to live its way into the very best of what it can be. This is how we save the nation. This is how America yet will be. Because we will make it so. Because we will work for voting rights. Because we will work for the rights and the dignity of all people. Because we will work to help this nation be and become the very best, the most beautiful, most loving and lovely, most thriving version of itself it can be. Friends, America will be. And we will make it so. So much love to you all. Amen. We close with these words from T.S. Eliot. What we call a beginning is often the end. And to make an end is to make a beginning. The end is where we start from. May we go forth into this beginning from this end. May we work with all our hearts and all our souls and all our creativity and all our compassion, may we build the America that will be. Amen.